I'm so excited to welcome two very exceptional guests to the Crystal Cathedral this morning, Ali Landre and her husband Alejandro. Now, Ali is an actress, a model, former Miss USA, not many years ago. Wow. She's probably best known for her famous Super Bowl commercials. Her husband, Alejandro, wrote and directed the 2007 Toronto Film Festival winning movie, Bella. Writer and director of that great movie, which is now, I think, being seen or will be shortly in the country. Two very attractive young people. Please welcome them today, Ali and her husband, Alejandro. Thank you very much. Ali, you look as young and as pretty as when you won the Miss USA contest.
You're so kind. That was, I guess, around 11 years ago.
Really? You don't look any older.
Yes, but the most exciting thing, I guess, that just happened for us is we have a brand new baby. Her name is Estella Inez. She's 8 weeks old.
Oh,
so that's our big joy in our life right now.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
But you look differently than you did on the Super Bowl commercials. You don't look like the same person.
Well, I would definitely say I'm not the same person inside. You know, I've always had God very present in my life since I was a young child, brought up in a wonderful family. But I guess not until about 4 years ago, I really felt his hand in my life. I felt like God took his hand and pulled me out of what could have potentially been a terrible life for me. I was in a relationship before I met my husband for 6 years with someone. I got married, and shortly after that, I found out that I had been betrayed in that relationship pretty much for the entire 6 years. I had never had anything bad happen to me in my life. I didn't know what to do. I couldn't find solace in anything, in my friends, in my mother, in my family. So I turned to the Word of God. Every single day for 4 to 5 months, I guess, I read the Bible. It was the only place I felt comfort. Every question I had, why did this happen to me? What did I do wrong? I would immediately go to the Word, and I felt such peace. It was the only place that I really had that peace. My father would ask me, why aren't you angry? And I couldn't be angry, because I saw then how blessed I was that because God was in my life, he took me out of something that could have been potentially, you know, a really terrible life for myself. And from that point on, I decided to change the way I walked in this world. I wanted to walk through this world in my life, in my personal life, in my career. I wanted everything to reflect how I felt in my heart. I wanted to make choices and decisions and that reflected how the person I was inside. It's very, very hard in the business we're in Hollywood, to live that way, you know, to have a career with our beliefs. So, you know, we've made that choice. We're standing firm in that. And that's why when Bella came along, this project, it was such a blessing.
Let me stop a moment. They may not know about the Bella project,
right.
Even though Eduardo, I think, was here.
Was here, Eduardo,
yes.
Right.
So enter this young man.
Yes.
Well, after the Super Bowl commercials.
That's right. Long after.
And how did you connect with her? You were a Christian, right?
Yes. Well, our good friend Eduardo, because we want to be in Hollywood and try to make a difference, what we did is we are my other business partner. His name is Leo Severino. He's a theologian, so he put together a theology class. And Eduardo saw Ali in one of the events and invited her. And that's where we literally met at a Bible study, which, you know, I knew that I had the seal from God. And, you know, from then until today, we have not been separated. So that's how we met.
Wonderful. So you were married?
Yeah, we're married. And like she said, we just had the biggest miracle a human being can experience alive, which is the birth of our daughter. So it was it's just been an amazing experience to be a father and be parents.
Fantastic. Tell me a little more about Bella. That movie is a great Christian movie.
Yeah, when Eduardo, who was here, you know, we met at my brother's restaurant, and we started talking about, you know, trying to change, you know, the media, because in today's world, you know, the media is one of the tools that are being used to poison the society and to poison the minds of the youth. So we were trying to figure out how to make films that, you know, could elevate the human dignity. And we started reading different scripts, and we couldn't find anything that really kind of, you know, touch, that we know had the potential to touch people's hearts. So that's when I went and I wrote this film literally for Eduardo to play the role. And, you know, one thing that I always keep in mind is kind of like what St. Francis said, you know, go to the world, preach the gospel, and only if necessary use words.
So that's good. Repeat that. Preach the gospel
only if necessary use words.
Yeah.
So it's a film that it celebrates life, celebrates family, and it's a film that it's a love story, but it's a love story that goes beyond romance. It's a love story between two characters that are broken, that become each other's redemption through pain, you know. I actually brought a little clip of the film that I would like to show you.
Okay, see if they can put it on screen.
I can't have this baby and watch it suffer with me.
It took 4 years of my life, and I took everything she had.
We were worried, we were busy, and you bailed out on us. You abandoned your flesh and blood.
And that won the People's Choice Award at the Toronto Film Festival. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You know, there's one thing distinctive about this church. We believe that God gives us dreams. Last week I said He is the Almighty Dreamer of great dreams. He gives them to you. And He took you from the sexy ads mm-hmm. on Super Bowl mm-hmm. into the spiritual path you're on today.
That's right. It's very tempting, you know, what He's saying, because so many opportunities come your way. Like for myself, once I decided to sort of change my path and still stay in the career, the profession that I'm in, I had to pass on project after project. Every week I was saying no, no, no. Everybody thought I was crazy. You know, my agents dropped me. I had to find someone else to represent me. But I had to stand firm in what I believed, because God had blessed me so much. And I really felt the grace in my life, and I knew that it was possible. And I think that made me stronger. It gave me strength. But it's tough, and it's very tempting. But the rewards, like you said, are endless.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Everybody, go see Bella, B-E-L-L-A. It's on in some movie.
In October. Theater.
In October.
October 26th.
October 26th. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.